Boom! Day two of quarantine. We are here, day two of quarantine. Holy cow, man. We got day two of quarantine. How you like that, man? How you like that? Day two of quarantine. There's craziness going on outside. There's people being locked indoors. There's people getting arrested for breaking quarantine all across the world. We got lions being released in Russia to attack all the people that are outside when they're supposed to be inside. I mean, there is crazy stuff going on in the world, but we're right here. You're watching it. We're having a good time. You know, we're enjoying our quarantine. Everything's great here. You know, we're having a good old time. How are you? How are you doing today? Huh? How are you? Let's see what's going on out there on the chat. We got Black Star. Those beats are sick. I know, man. We made them. We got a production company right here where we make that stuff that is our own stuff. So it is great, great, great stuff. As you're looking right here, get on the mailing list. You know, we got this book coming out, Skits Comic. It's called Skits, The Sun, Book One. It's on Indiegogo. Go sign up. Get on the mailing list right now. It is going to be awesome. It's going to be great. And you'll get some perks for signing up early. You get some freebie stuff that we'll be sending out in a PDF. Also, you get some discounts day one. Discounts on books day one, you know. This is Skits. This is the book right here. These are our characters. This is our team. It's the Skits team. Got some artwork here. I went all through it yesterday, so I ain't going to belabor that too much. You know, we're going to just kind of roll through and show you some of the imagery here. We know y'all are going to really love this. You know, this is the book. Come check it out. Yesterday, I showed you on the stream if you weren't here. Yesterday, I showed you how you can make this type of image like you're seeing right here on the screen quick and easy, you know, and it doesn't take too long. So that's that. Let's get over to this. So the big news right now, the thing I was reading, Bleeding Cool's website, Jeppy, he's the owner and CEO of Diamond Comics Distributors. He has released a statement that Diamond Comics Distributors was closing its doors for the foreseeable future for all new product as a result of the coronavirus pandemic affecting the comics industry and everything else. So no comics are being shipped. No comics. How y'all feel about that, man? No comics. Well, I'll tell you what, you know, Diamond may not be shipping you your Marvel, DC, Image books and all that, but what you can do, Alterna's still here. Alterna Comics. You can go get you some Alterna comics. Go over there to Alterna and check out what they got for sale. They're still shipping, printing, and everything else. You can get whatever you want from Peter Cimetti over there at Alterna Comics. Go check out what he has. He's got all sorts of good books over there. So yeah, go check that out. Let's go on back here to this. And actually, let's just show some artwork while we talk about some other things here. I mean, let's just show people what we got. So let's go over to the chat, see what's going on. We got Burst Films saying what's up. Also got Burst Films. YouTube didn't pop this up. I heard about it on Twitter. Yeah, you know, someone actually who has some contacts with YouTube, YouTube says that there's a bug in the system. There's a ghost in the system, a ghost in the shell over there at YouTube. And they just don't have enough people to work on it, I guess. So a lot of people are being like shadow blocked or shadow banned. You know, their live feeds aren't coming up. I'm sure that's probably what's happening here too, you know, but I mean, there's nothing that can really be done about that. They'll get to it when they get to it is what they said. So that's fine. You know, we'll just see what happens. Well, if people got direct comics from the creator, then this wouldn't be a problem. Exactly. I mean, that's why we're here, right? I mean, we are here to talk about that. You know, it's like we got all sorts of good comics going on. Go over Indiegogo, check it out, sign up for the mailing list. That's a great thing right there. So, yep. Cool, cool. Black Star. We love alternative comics. I know, man. We got like they have this box sale that they do where it's like a whole box of number ones and you get like 27 books or something like that. It's like 27 books in one box, all number ones. It's like all their main I guess it's all their titles. And you get this whole big box that's like 35, 40 bucks or something like that. I can't quite remember how much it was, but it was awesome, man. There's a whole bunch of number ones just bam right there, you know. We got Burst Films. I call Red Heron. All right, you know. Well, if you're in Russia, they call a line, so you'll be all right there. Yep, there it is. Putting it in there. Thanks for putting those links in there for me. I really appreciate that. So I'm going to go to the big screen here. That's funny. Because something I wanted to talk about today is drawing the figure. You know, it's like an aids for drawing the figure, things that help you out. You know, it's like when you're learning how to draw, something that I did when I was younger is I thought that everyone drew from their heads. So that's what I did. I just looked at figures. I looked at drawings. I looked at people. And I figured out how to draw just from learning from life. And I memorized all that stuff in my head. I was like, okay, here's how you draw a hand. Here's how you draw an arm. Here's head, face, all that sort of stuff. I just memorized it all myself. And then when I went off to art college, I found out that hardly no one does that, that they just do it all from guides, you know, like they'll use photo reference, they'll use whatever type of reference they can get, they'll use, but photo reference is a big one, and that's how they draw, you know. So when I started using references for drawing and stuff like that, I was like, holy cow, this is crazy. I you know, this is like a whole new world. This is easy. It's all right in front of me. I mean, I can draw whatever I can see instead of whatever's in my head. So today, when I do drawings of figures and stuff like that, I use a few different visual aids. Sometimes I'll do, you know, I got a mirror where I can look at my own facial features. I got some photo references, and I got these little figures that I use. I got these. I got a couple of different ones. I'm gonna show you what they are. So this right here, this is kind of new. This was an Indiegogo that was done. And I gotta tell you what, I backed this thing and it took them 2 years to get it to me. 2 years. You can go over to their website right now and buy one and you'll probably get it in a week. But I backed it on Indiegogo and it took them 2 years to get this done. But this thing's really cool here. See, you can pose it any way you want. It's got little fingers. It's got the head you can move around. It's got magnetic hands and magnetic feet. So it comes with this metal plate here, and you can just kind of set them on there, and you can move them around and get whatever types of poses you want there. So that's really, really cool. And that's, you know, I use it as just kind of a visual guide where it's like, how would it look if the arm was in front of his face doing this motion, and then how would the legs be behind him? You know, it just gives a lot of good reference stuff like that. You know, it's just really good benefit. Now, what I also do is I have this armature attached to my computer right here, and I have a figure sitting on it, right? So what I'm able to do is I'm able to pose them, you know, get in all sorts of crazy positions. I can bend them all over the place, and I got it right here next to the monitor for when I'm doing my thumbnails for the comic, and I can put that just right there. I put it right in front of my screen, and I'm able to draw right here and have a little bit of visual guide in front of me for drawing those actual people there. So that's really, really cool and insightful right there. Now, what I had before this, something that I had before this was I had these little anime figures, right? You know, they come on these little, they got the this little case here where it's got extra hands and swords and cell phones and stuff like that in there. And, you know, so you can change out the parts. These are okay. These aren't bad. They're cheap, you know. You can buy them. I think they're, you can get them on Amazon for like 25 bucks or something like that, 30 bucks. But I think they're really geared towards the manga community. But, I mean, they're cool. You know, they work. They don't have a good range of motion to them. I will say. Range of motion. And that's kind of, I'll get on the body and the joints. Yeah, we got a little bit of a lag, don't we, El Gargoyle? Hey, thanks for coming in, man. Everyone working? Yeah, we're still working here, man. I mean, we work from home, so that's no big deal. No big deal. You know, yeah, we got the slowdown. I think that's what it is. You know, old internet problems. Everyone's on the internet right now. That's the big thing. So I'll just leave it small. I think that's probably what's doing it. But here's another figure. You can get these online. These have like a rubber on them. And you can get all the mom stuff. These are actually pretty darn. But that's pretty cool, you know. So those are some of the guides that I use for drawing, you know. There's photograph. Reference. I mean, a lot of most. I know that could possibly be it as well, you know. El Gargoyle there saying hello to a few people in chat. Stay safe. Stay safe. Say it. Get it out. I'm a little tongue-tied, man. It's hard. We got free product review and free art. Exactly, man. Free product review, free art, man. Got all sorts of cool stuff here, you know. So I just wanted to do one more little thing for y'all. And then we'll probably to happy for combine. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna leave this out with little bit of video. So yeah, there we go. Got some good stuff. No sketch today there, Verse Films. We just wanted to kind of talk about a few things and give people an update. You know, you got to have an update because we're going to have to do another update. And then we'll also bring up go for. That's an awesome concept art book. And what we'll do is I'll kind of show you some of the good parts and bad parts of this book right here. There's all sorts of good stuff in here. So anyway, we'll thanks a lot for stopping by. We'll see y'all tomorrow, man. Have a good come get some being uploaded right now, so go check that out. Come get some tonight. Come get some.